Talk presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And down he goes at about the 45. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Made around the 48-yard line. Not much there for the halfback, but he picked up some tough yardage.
Well, nothing fancy here. The back did a nice job of putting his head down and getting the first down.
And he's tackled right around the 40.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
From the 40-yard line, first down. And he is drilled at the 30-yard line. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy.
Drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Makes it to the 21.
That makes it second and 2.
Frustrating for this offense to go backwards, but they've just got to stick with it and know that big plays will eventually happen.
This is the 8th play of this drive. This one's going deep to the end zone. No, incomplete.
That wasn't necessarily a big hit. It was a smart play, avoiding the penalty, but making sure to get there in time to break up the score.
Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Trying to take the lead by a field goal. Kicks away. And he nails the long field goal. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He makes it to the 28-yard line. The Knights and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
Change your quarterback, Herbie. You got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy. It's second and 5 here. Ball on their own 33. Caught with room to work. And he shoved out of bounds around the 42-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Now this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver. And the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
They give to the tailback. He gets hit out of bounds at the 48-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. He has some room. He's at the 30, brought down at the 22-yard line.
A run like that usually ignites the offense. So let's see if they can stay on a roll.
Out to about the 21. Second and nine coming up here. Ball on the 21-yard line. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Scrambling. They bring the quarterback down. Fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. This would tie it. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he just got stood up right there. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Loss of two by the halfback. From their own 26-yard line. Second down. And they make the stop at the 47. His way to about the 42. First and 10, ball on the 42. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
So at the end of one, and this one's knotted up at three. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we're dead even. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. Chucks it downfield. The 10. It's complete. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. A nice six-play, 72-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's taken down at the 39. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. The pitch, and he's got some room. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 27-yard line.
First down here, Brad, by this offense. The receiver's running the football. You got to think, as a defensive coordinator, it's one thing to try to defend it, kind of your traditional offensive attack. But here you got to start worrying about what is this wide receiver going to do. It puts a lot of pressure on the defense and the defensive mindset on how they want to try to slow this offense down.
Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. Throws it in a hurry.
Let's see if this coaching staff sticks with the short passing game or if they decide to open it up a bit more.
That brings up second and nine.
Throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football and check it down or take off and run with it.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
It's fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. The kick is up, and it is good. They line up to kick this one away. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
You're not going to see this very often from this running back. He just got gobbled up pretty deep in the backfield.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on their own 22. A 3-yard pickup.
Well, it's a good job here to just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Flares it and almost had it intercepted. He's to the 40, and he's hammered down. The Knights struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how it can do. They got to get the ball in his hands somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch to get this guy going because he has that kind of ability, and up to this point, they've not been able to find a way to get him the ball. Give credit. A lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
Right there, gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. And they got it.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far this
week. Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He steps out at the 23. Second and seven. Ball on the 23-yard line. He gets rid of this one.
Defense was playing the run all the way, and they got it right. Nice work.
The Knights taking their first time out of the half. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. And he's taken down at the 43.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to their opponent's territory.
And he just gets rid of it. From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. Hit and still completed it. Tackle at the 47-yard line.
Gaining 4 yards. Third down.
And he throws it away.
Very stern effort there by the defense. They weren't giving up anything on that series.
This one is a beauty. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Fires out to his receiver. And he's taken down at the 29-yard line. Second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Taken down right around the 28-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Low scoring first half of play, but a close game. The Knights lead it 10-6.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. From the 7. Gets to about the 27-yard line. The Knights continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. They complete that play-action pass. Good for 7 yards.
All it takes is a second on these play-action fakes to get the defense out of position. And that's how this tight end was able to get open and pick up some yards.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Gets to around the 42. That makes it first and 10.
Two ties. Four down.
A gain of 8 on the carry.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and 2.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Runs it, and he stops short of the line of scrimmage.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
Is still on the field. They're all tied in on the line here on fourth and short. He's tackled around the 48-yard line, and the defense comes through.
Well, the offense looked like they wanted to bounce the ball to the outside. This defense just has too much speed. It did a good job of shutting off the edge and preventing the ball carrier from getting to the first down.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Nice gain as he works the right side. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Offense lines up in a 5-wide set. The defense anticipating pass here. Looks left, picked off. And now he's got room to run. He's at the 30. Tackle made at the 20. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
From the 20-yard line, first down.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
Down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it third and one.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. That's a 4 yard gain there for the tailback.
Well, the important thing is they were able to pick up the first down. And they're really starting to show how much they're relying on this halfback to do all of the work. And right now, he's looking pretty good.
Brought down at the 7. Nowhere to that play action pass completion. In second and goal. 7 yards for the touchdown. Down.
He's got a nose for the end zone. What more can you say? He wasn't giving up on that run until he was in for the score.
Trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 22-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. The pitch, look out, loose ball. Not a good time to fumble the football.
And that guy feels horrible about it. He's got to forget about it. Go out there and play hard the next time they hit the field.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. On the run. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
Good stop there by the freshman. You got to be careful with this offensive attack because one missed tackle could mean trouble.
It's second and 9. Ball on the 20-yard line. Quick throw. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
From the 16-yard line, third down. That's a great tackle at the 26-yard line.
That brings us to 15.
The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he got it. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the offense. No doubt looking to take better care of the ball on this drive.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
You're not going to be able to get by a sure tackler like this linebacker too often.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Quick pass. He gets hit out of bounds. At the 40-yard line, we head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. The Knights in front by six. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. Makes it out to about the 50. He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
They'll bring him down around the 39-yard line. From the 39-yard line, it's first down. Tackled after a decent pickup. Makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. They come out on an empty backfield. And a quick throw. And they make the stop right around the 16-yard line. Got a first and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. The 10. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. This is the ninth play of this drive. Go with the toss, and he's level at the 6-yard line. From the 6-yard line, second down. He tackles him for a loss. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Just under three to go in regulation. Nice play fake. End zone picked off. Oh, no, they really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
First and 10, ball on the 20. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Tight. pushed out of bounds. It's first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. He makes his way to about the 42.
I think the defense is starting to be concerned about the outcome of this game. That was a huge first down by the offense, and at this point, you wonder if the defense can make a play to get their own offense back out of the field.
He fights forward to about the 40. He gains a couple of yards on the carry. The Knights use their second timeout. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Tackle around the 37-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. Third and 5 situation. Ball on the 37. Receiver's got the first down, and he's taken down around the 23-yard line. Here's the 8th play of the series. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Game 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And he hits him hard at the 8-yard line. And this is the 10th play of the drive. The Knights coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team is able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
Things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.